Now, I'm not sure how many of you guys out there are into camping in the wilderness, but boy, do I got the story to tell you. And it's about wolves! However, before we get into this very intense story, allow me to quickly shout out today's sponsor. Before today's video begins, I'd like to let you all know that today's video was sponsored by Piroshki on 3rd. If you're ever in the Seattle, Washington region, be sure to drop into Piroshki on 3rd and try some of their delicious varieties of bakery goods. From their cakes and desserts to their famous line of piroshkis, Piroshki on 3rd is the place to be to satisfy your bakery and cafe goods. And I mean, just look at all the stuff they have on their website. Oh my goodness, guys, how could you not want to drop into this place? I'm getting hungry looking at all this stuff. But if you'd like to know more about Piroshki on 3rd, then be sure to check their website down in the description below for more information. Again, that's Piroshki on 3rd in Seattle, Washington. And check it out during your next visit. So you guys want to hear a good story, eh? Well, allow me to just jump right into it. So this story takes place a few years ago when I happened to be heading up to Seattle to visit some friends. Seattle, if you didn't know, is a beautiful rainforest area which is full of nature and wildlife, as you would expect, which makes it the perfect getaway for anyone out there that's into camping, nature walks, and etc. And well, that's exactly what I'm into. Yes, your boy likes nature a lot, and well, I don't really think that's a weird thing. I mean, I like technology and all, but come on. What beats disconnecting from your phone and computer and getting into our nature world? No? No one? Okay, just let me continue. Anywho, the thing about this entire trip wasn't about what happened in Seattle, but rather what happened before. You see, I practically live on the opposite end of North America, and Seattle is not a one-stop flight from where I live. So I ended up having to take a detour to Toronto for a few days, which I'm sure you've heard me beat to heck that I lived there for a few years. So after I got my videos ready to upload and packed my suitcase, I was on my way over to Toronto to stop for a few days before heading to Seattle. Now, if you're wondering why I stopped over there, it's because I just wanted to see some friends. And things were really great because I was able to crash at a couple of friends' houses and take in a lot of the different changes in scenery, which was really nice as well. Not too long after that, I was able to hang with another good friend of mine that lived a bit farther away from the city, but still relatively close. And we had a super fun time. My friend, let's call Rose, loved to sing and go on adventures, and well, your boy also happened to dig that, so while we hung out, we got in her car and went out on a little adventure. She brought her guitar and I brought my ukulele, even though I can't really play it and well, and we sat on our journey together. Not long after the drive, we found a really nice spot behind some kind of school close to the woods and parked our car there to relax. She pulls out her guitar and I take out my ukulele and we just start casually playing tunes while we chill and talk about life and stuff. So here we are just parked in a parking lot behind a school, just playing some music and relaxing, when all of a sudden, I realized it was beginning to get a little late, and we soon needed to head back to her place because, well, I also needed to get going soon as well. As we were chilling out in the car, the two front doors were open because it was a really nice summer day, and well, it was just too hot to keep the doors closed. And I don't know if you know this, but holding a guitar in the car is also not really comfortable, so it allowed us to have some more room to play instruments. So I bet you're wondering, Jordan, when exactly does this story get interesting? Where are the wolves you talked about? Well, little Jimmy boy, let me continue. As we were talking, I looked in the rearview mirror and noticed that I saw something move, but I wasn't really sure what it was at first glance. It almost seemed to be like some sort of animal, but I didn't immediately assume that, so I kind of just shrugged it off. Not too long after that, I noticed another movement in my rearview mirror. At this point, I could tell it was some kind of animal, but I definitely started to get a little worried, as we were in the middle of nowhere, and I mean, like, this school was close to the woods, but we were not close to civilization. And it was unlikely to be some sort of dog or cat just hanging around. After seeing something move in the rearview mirror again, I turned to my friend Rose and told her to immediately shut her door. She, of course, got a little scared because she had no idea why I suddenly got so serious. After she shut her door, I had turned over to shut mine, and that's when I saw it. A massive wolf, literally 20 feet away from me in a parking lot, staring me down with its sharp eyes. It began to run to the car, and I so ever quickly gasped to shut the door as fast as possible. Thankfully, I did so in the nick of time, but after turning to my friend to point out the wolf I had seen, on her side there was also another wolf close by, which immediately put me into a panic mode, which at this moment I realized that we were clearly being hunted by these wolves, and that there were probably others in the area as well, which was freaking terrifying, man. Immediately, I turned the car on, and we just get the hell out of there as fast as we could, and we eventually make our way back to her place. The wolves got out of her way when I moved, but as you'd expect, I didn't really try and pay too much attention other than getting out of there when I could. Thankfully, we were both safe and reacted quickly in a situation that could have otherwise been very bad. After coming down with Rose and realizing we probably just escaped a terrible fate, I say goodbye to her and I head to the airport because it wasn't too long after that that I then had to go to Seattle. And when I flew to Seattle, it was an amazing time. And I actually happened to check out Piroshki on 3rd, which sponsored this video. And guys, I'm telling you, it's definitely a restaurant you want to check out next time you're in the area. But either way, I spent a week in Seattle, and then I went back home to live another day and tell another story. So that being said, guys, that is all I have for you today. I hope you did enjoy the story, and if you did, be sure to leave a like and subscribe for more videos. All right, guys, until next time, have a great day. See ya! We'll be right back.